They have 650 lights at least. It's a massive sort of lighting show. And of course, the equipment as far as sound is concerned almost equals the light. So it's pretty big as hardware, yes.
Yeah.
Actually, I think Freddie's also brought a vacuum cleaner as well. So.
Oh, well, that's nice. I'm sure it'll be really excellent all around. They've been together for 14 years now, and their background is interesting because they're all from an academic background.
That's right. They came from a school in London, got together, and as Brian May said to me the other night, that in fact he didn't really seriously take the group that they would go into the charts and become so big as they did. Then, of course, the evolution of Queen happened, and it just kept amazing them all. And then, of course, they went into the punk rock stage of where they'd become a mega group, and everyone said, well, they're finished.
Yeah.
And they switched it right around, and congratulations to them.
And now, as an analyst to the whole thing, oh, that's a good word, isn't it? As an analyst to the whole thing, Molly, how do you think they survived the punk rock thing? Because they did.
Well, I think the talent, and I've always said this, talent alone, as far as a singer-songwriter, will shine out. And I think not only with Queen, we had Alan Lancaster in here tonight as well. Status Quo held that for so long because they had the talent as songwriters and as performers. And I think when you look at the charts now, and you've got Glenn Frey from the Eagles, and you've got, just so many people that have been there for such a long time but have the ability to have the talent to sing and write songs, it always shines through.
Yeah. Would you say they are the pioneers of the video clip?
Sorry?
Would you say they are the pioneers of the video clip with Bohemian Rhapsody? I mean, so many people seem to be claiming to be the pioneers of the video clip thing.
Well, funny enough, I mean, Bohemian Rhapsody, and I don't know whether they realised it at the time, or Bruce Gowers, who was in fact an English director, realised it at the time. But that particular clip, because it was so magnificent, was in fact, I think, the start of video taking over and having a great influence on the rock music, not only in this country, but throughout the world. It was a magnificent clip.
All right, well, let's have a look at part of that right here and now.
Okay.
Bismillah, no, we will not let you go.
Let him go.
Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Let him go.
Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Let me go.
We will not let you go.
Let me go.
We will not let you go.
Let me go.
Mamma mia,
mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub has the devil put aside for me, for me, for me.
This time, how long have they been on stage now?
They've been on stage for about, I guess, an hour now, and they are absolutely slaughtering the crowd. And ironically enough, as you came out of that clip, they've just finished a song, so the applause was just deafening on both ears.
Right. Okay, thank God they're both still working after all this time.
But I might say that with the Bohemian Rhapsody clip, very quickly, that Bruce Gowers, in fact, was the godfather of video clips, and our own Russell Mulcahy went across to London and, in fact, joined a company with Bruce Gowers. He took him under his wing, and, of course, Russell Mulcahy, he's done so many things with Elton and goodness knows who, Duran Duran. And Bruce Gowers really was the father of video for rock and roll, I really believe.
Okay, now we have a film clip here, and I'm just going to have to follow you here because you know how the concert's going, and I'm in the dark a little. although well lit, I'm still in the dark. So let's have a look at them running out on stage to give people an idea of the excitement when they enter tonight.
Okay. Hope you have a good time. Brian, Roger.
Thanks, Molly.
And John, have a good concert.
Actually disbanded for a while, didn't they? Why was that?
Well, I think...
went quiet for a while.
Yeah, I think that they... every group that's been together for so long decide to have a rest. Unfortunately, with the Beatles, they decided to, after a while, that it wasn't the marriage, as John Lennon said it, did not work. But I think that that everyone expected the Beatles always to stay together. And I think with every group now, they have to have that rest away from each other. I mean, obviously they have their own lives, they get married, they have their own children, and they must get away from each other. And that's how it successfully works. And with Queen, it really does do that.
Right. Well, we're going to take a break now. We'll come back in a moment and probably catch up with the performance by then. Molly, at backstage, I'm going to let you cue us to the song on stage because I believe it's coming up.
Right.
But I just want to ask you, there is a story that Freddie's going to make a solo album. Does that just mean that he's sort of having a bit of freedom on his own, or does that mean that they are really thinking of splitting up?
No, no way at all. In fact, I spoke to John and the whole boys before. No splitting up. Just a solo album, and the boys will do another Queen album. And meanwhile, we're about to go in and hooray for St Kilda. You finally won a game, boys.